Town Council meeting to order. We'll start with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. The purpose of tonight's meeting is it's a public hearing on the 79E application submitted by Newmarket Mills LLC. I'm going to read a couple of things. I'll read the public hearing notice first off. And there's a couple of sections out of the 79E chapter that I will read mainly for those people at home so they can understand what we're doing here tonight. So, Town of Newmarket, New Hampshire, Town Council Public Hearing, October 13th, 2010, 7 p.m., Town Council Chambers. Excuse me. Public hearing. The Newmarket Town Council is holding a public hearing on the application of the Newmarket Mills LLC under the Community Revitalization Tax Relief Incentive Program to determine if the Town Council shall provide for short-term property assessment tax relief and a related covenant to protect the public benefit to encourage substantial rehabilitation and use of the Main Street Mills. Said rehabilitation shall transform 200,000 square feet of vacant mill space into mixed-use residential, commercial, and public/civic space. Said hearing is required by RSA 79E:4-2, Community Revitalization Tax Relief Incentive. All right, I'm going to read a couple of sections out of the 79E, mainly for the people at home. Section 79E:4 states, upon receipt of an application, the governing body shall hold a duly noticed public hearing to take place no later than 60 days from receipt of the application. To determine whether the structure at issue is a qualifying structure, whether any proposed rehabilitation qualifies as substantial rehabilitation, and whether there is a public benefit to granting the requested tax relief, and if so, for what duration. No later than 45 days after the public hearing, the governing body shall render a decision granting or denying the requested tax relief, and if so, granting, establishing the tax relief period. The governing body may grant tax relief provided the governing body finds a public benefit under 79E:7, and the specific public benefit is preserved through a covenant under RSA 79E:8, and the governing body finds that the proposed use is consistent with the municipality's master plan or development regulations. There's much more to that section, but I think that was a pertinent section. Then another pertinent section is section 79E:7, which defines the public benefit. Public benefit. In order to qualify for tax relief under this chapter, the proposed substantial rehabilitation must provide at least one of the public benefits, and the proposed replacement must provide one or more of the public benefits to a greater degree than what a substantial rehabilitation of the same qualifying structure as follows. Excuse me. One, it enhances the economic vitality of the downtown. Two, it enhances and improves a structure that is culturally or historically important on a local, regional, state, or national level, either independently or within the context of an historic district, town center, or village center in which the building is located. Three, it promotes development of municipal centers providing for efficiency, safety, and a greater sense of community consistent with RSA 9B, or it increases residential housing in urban or town centers. So, having read those, the purpose of the meeting tonight is to basically gather information. There will be no vote tonight. I expect that we will hear from Mr. Chinberg first, explaining what it is he is looking for, and then we'll open it up to the public for any comments or questions you may have. This is all just going to go into the record for the decision to be made by the council. So with that, I will open the floor up to Mr. Chinberg to explain the application, please.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I'm Eric Chinberg. I'm the manager and owner of Newmarket Mills LLC, which is the owner of the Main Street Mills in downtown Newmarket. I've been before the town now for a couple of years getting permits and entitlements to do a substantial renovation of the mills downtown, which include office and retail space, civic space, apartments, live-work space. The timing of my endeavor has coincided with a very difficult climate in the realm of financing, and I've had difficulty in obtaining the financing necessary to complete this project. I have, the only way that this project can happen is through a combination of equity that I've put in, a loan from a traditional lender, a bank, and a combination of tax credits, both the historic tax credit, which is a federal program, and the new markets tax credit, which is also a federal program to encourage development in certain census tracts. This property qualifies for both the historic and the new markets tax credit, without which I would not be able to do this project at this time, based on the credit environment and the uncertainty of general uncertainty in the economy. So I've assembled a, through the New Hampshire Business Finance Authority, they have allocated to me, which is not the same as getting the money, but they've said, we're willing to set aside an allocation of tax credits if you can get a U.S. corporation to buy the tax credits. I've also had the site qualified and accepted by the United States Department of the Interior for historic tax credits, provided I can get the new markets tax credits and the traditional loan. I have received a, Kennebunk Savings Bank has expressed its willingness to lend into the project, provided we can meet certain criteria, which I can't quite meet. So the overall project is on the order of $19+ million. The current credit environment is such that lenders who used to lend 80, 85, maybe even 90% of a project cost are now lending 65, if you're lucky, 70%. So in a project like this, it leaves a pretty large gap, some of which can be filled with these tax credits. The thing that precipitated this request is that in this uncertain environment, everybody's taken a very conservative tack, including appraisers. So the appraisal came in too low to support the lender's loan that would close the gap between what I can put in and what the tax credits can provide. So I approached the town I talked to the appraiser and the bank. The biggest challenge in creating a property like this, which must be at least for the 5 or 7 years initially, it must be a rental project, because the tax credits that you can get to make these projects work will only work if they remain owned by the development entity for 5 to 7 years, 5 for the historic, 7 for the new markets. So it must remain as a rental project for at least that period of time. In order to assess the value of a rental project, the appraiser simply takes your expected rents minus your expected costs and says this is what the income is of the project, and that determines the value of it. I can't change what the projected rents will be, and I can't control any costs but for potentially the cost of property tax. And property tax represents by a factor of almost 3 times the largest single expense in operating a property like this. So in talking with the bank, the tax credit people, and the appraiser, if I can, during the period that the tax credit people care, which is 5 to 7 years, increase the net operating income by lowering my expenses, I can have the appraisal go up, which gets the bank into the position where they'll lend the money, and the project can proceed in a single phase $19 million project. So what I've done is I've tried to figure out, you know, what would happen if I don't get this tax relief versus what if I do. I'm invested in this project. I've through loans and friends and family and my equity, and I've got over $1 million invested into a project that I believe in and will stick with. The big question on the 79E is a matter of timing. If I can get all the tax credit financing and the debt and everything all at once, which this would provide a huge tool to making that happen, I would hope to be able to close the $19 million transaction, the financing, in the next 4 or 5 months. And we, in the next 10, 11 months beyond that, would build it all out. And it would just be a single phase project that's done. What Newmarket has done to their downtown has made it a wonderful place. Nobody's questioning the absorption analysis that we're doing on the apartments. People assume this is a great place to live and people are gonna wanna come live here. There is a challenge that we've had to increase the amount of commercial space in the building, and that's a tax credit rule that a certain amount of the income has to be commercial and not residential. That scared the bank further because they know that the apartments will rent. They're more concerned about the commercial space, and it's made them more conservative in their willingness to lend the money. So all that being said, I've spoken to the bank, to the appraiser, and I've determined kind of what the gap is. And the gap on a net present value basis, the project cost is around $19 million. I needed it to appraise at $18 million. It appraised at $15 million. Since then, I've been able to, through correcting a few assumptions of the appraiser and giving some information that was left out, get the appraisal up some. But I need a net present value increase of about $600,000 to have this happen. And so I have come up with an idea whereby this RSA allows the town, by the way, I think this project meets all four of the public benefits, not just the one that's required. I think it meets all four, and that's fine and good. Because it's an historic structure, you could ask for 9 years of full tax relief, and that essentially, whatever it's worth now, I'll pay those taxes, and whatever you put in, the incremental rise in assessed value would be delayed for up to 9 years. I don't need that. What the scenario that I've proposed is that the first 3 years after completion, there would not be an increase in the taxes based on the improvements. For the next 2 years, it would be assessed at 50% of that improvement. After that, it would be at par. And just a couple of things that the tax credit investors are wary, and they control this. They are willing to, the tax credit will bring in enough money to acquire additional parcels that I don't necessarily have to acquire now if we do the whole deal. There's multiple parcels that were assembled here. I've purchased some from the NCDC, and I have options and obligations to purchase others from the town. Combined purchase price of about $1.2 million. If I get the 79E and I can close the whole deal, that $1.2 million comes in next February or March when we close. So even though I'm asking for a net present value discount over the next 5 years of about $600,000, you'd get almost twice that in cash when we closed the loan, because I would at that moment buy the Eagles property, the Riverdale property, the parking lots property, and pay up front all the impact fees, which is $300,000. When you add all those up, it's $1.2 million, $1.3 million, something like that, that would come in as cash to the town that wouldn't come in otherwise. So if I were to receive, the reasonable question is, if you don't get 79E, what do you do? We would slog it out. We would, I own the property, we have tenants, and right now in this environment, I own other mills that we haven't had the benefit of a big tax credit deal. So when we get a new tenant that wants to take 5,000 feet and we can now renovate and spend $300,000 or whatever it costs to fix that space up, you go to the bank. The bank says, yep, I'll lend you $300,000 because you've got a tenant that's going to service that debt, and we're good with that. And that could happen, maybe at that pace, $300,000 a year of added value that we could continue to do. So that's why I opened by saying it's not a question of, you know, that I'm going to walk away. I'm not going to walk away. It would just be a question of timing. If I can get all this stuff to happen and get the big loan, we'll do the whole project in 2011. And a year from now, we'll be just about to open our doors, and you'll have 19 or 12. Well, assessed value is different than cost, but you'll have, I'm guessing, a $12 million increase in your assessed valuation. So I've created two little bar charts. Actually, I didn't. There's a guy. Actually, maybe you could just take one of each and pass them down. Well, let me keep one of each so I know what I said. Thanks. There's two charts here. A The title's at the bottom. One is estimated cumulative tax revenue over the next 10 years, with or without 79E. The other is estimated cumulative total cash to the town, which brings in the metric of buying those lots that I wouldn't necessarily buy otherwise. So start with the one that says estimated cumulative tax revenue. The light blue is the assumption that I would not get the tax credit deal and I would continue to find tenants and invest $300,000 a year into the value of the building. The purple is, even with the discounts I'm proposing, what the tax revenue would be with the 79E and I got the full closing done. Because the other thing that happens, if I get the whole deal done, I end up buying Eagles, Riverdale, the parking lots, and all that. Well, now that's land that you guys own that nobody's paying you property tax on. So I'm not arguing that if I buy a property and it's worth, if I buy the Eagles for $369, I'm not asking you to not charge me for that because that's what it's worth now. I'd be paying those taxes. 79E is only asking for a delay in increased value. So this is just a summary that says if I added $300,000 a year, not buying those other properties, just limping along and doing this without the whole deal, the cumulative tax revenue to the town would, at the end of 10 years, would be about $900,000. At the end of 10 years, if I had 79E, it'd be about $2.2 million. And it actually breaks even very early. If you look at these charts, by three years from now, it's pretty much even. So if you go to the other chart, it's even more dramatic because the other chart takes into account the $1.2 million that I'd be paying next February, and that looks at cumulative cash. After 10 years, I would have paid cash to the town of in the order of $3.5 million versus about $1.3 million otherwise. The $1.3 million, Chairman Bottoman, just so you know, includes, I know that I got to buy Eagles whether I do the tax credit deal or not. So that 1.3 includes paying for Eagles by next June. So that's a summary, and I would be happy to take any questions or respond to any comments from the public.
All right, let's start first with any councils. Any councils have any questions at this point? Want to start hearing some testimony? Okay, for now, thank you, Mr. Chinberg.
Yep.
With that, I'll open it up to anybody else that has any comments. Please state your name and address for the record, please.
Roseanne Quox, Wadley Falls Road, Newmarket. I had a couple of concerns. I'm kind of on the fence about this. It sounds good, and, you know, in my mind, as long as it's done right. First of all, I thought that the NCDC was going to be paying the town when somebody bought the, that the NCDC would be paying the town for the Eagles when somebody signed on the dotted line.
I think that was the original agreement, and then that agreement, then there was an agreement between the town and NCDC that the developer would pay for that when they bought it.
It's a sign-off.
Right, okay.
Okay, and I think things like that, it would be great if the public knew that in advance, just so that we know exactly what's going on with the finances of the town, because we put that money out.
That's been a document that's been in place for several years. That's not a change. That document's been in place for several years.
All right. Now, the only problem I have is when the applicant applied to the town council, the governing body, their application for the tax relief incentive, it has to be done according to 79E by the owner of the property. And at the time that this application was presented to the governing body, it was not owned by Mr. Chinberg, but he was listed as the owner. Even in planning board, if you're going before the planning board and you are not the owner of the property, you have to have a letter prepared for the planning board to let them know that you are not the owner and that the owner gives you permission to discuss this with the planning board. And even on the front page of the application for this relief through 79E, it has two sections. It has owner's name and address, and it has another side for the owner's name or the applicant's name if different from owner. So that tells me that we have to and should have had the owner's name on here in order for this application to be complete. And in my mind, especially with any people in the mills, they have any problems with the legality of this, I think that could be something that they could probably go to court on, stating that this application was not complete at the time it was presented to the governing body. And another question.
Roseanne, can I stop you for a minute?
Sure.
There? With all due respect, we disagree with you.
Mm-hmm.
I understand what you're saying. We were made aware that the application was not made by the owner. That's been remedied tonight. Mr. Chinberg owns it. We've been advised by legal counsel that we are on solid footing going forward with the hearing. So.
And may I ask, when did he buy it? When did he become the legal owner of the property?
I don't know when he became the legal owner.
When the application was made, it was clear on the face of it that the owner was NCDC and that the applicant's name was New Market Mills. I advised the council at that time that they could not hear the application unless the applicant was in fact the owner.
Mm-hmm.
They said the expectation was that was going to occur prior to the hearing that had been scheduled. I advised them that as long as the owner was the applicant at the time of the hearing, that would satisfy the statute.
Thank you.
So this board has no problem with this application. You feel that this application is complete, even though it was not the owner. And again, does maybe Mr. Chinberg or NCDC could let us know when he became the owner of the property?
To answer your question, yes, we are comfortable that the application is complete and we're on strong legal footing to go forward.
And can I get an answer as to when Mr. Chinberg became the legal owner of the property?
Please go up to the microphone, please.
I would just like to clarify that the application was filled out correctly. At the time that I filled out the application, I was the applicant, New Market Mills LLC, and I listed clearly NCDC as the owner. As of today, I am also the owner. New Market Mills LLC is the owner as of today.
And has it had time to be recorded in the Rockingham Registry of Deeds?
Yes.
It has been. But
Well, excuse me, Roseanne, could you just put all questions this way?
I
don't want conversation going on out in the audience.
Yeah. So it's already been done that way, but it states in RSE 79E that the application shall be made by the owner. And the owner at the time was the NCDC, but they weren't the one applying for the tax incentive.
Understood.
So I feel that it should be done over quickly just to make sure you're legal. I don't think
okay.
It's right.
Thank you. Anybody else?
Hi, Renan Cohen, 81 Bay Road. I don't want to speak too loud. And also president of New Market Main Street Corporation. Would like to present an opinion in favor of the 79E application that's being transacted or being at least publicly heard tonight. For the break-even time of 2 years and Eric Chinberg only asking for help with the improvements on the value, not the whole value of the entire property, but just the improvements on it. I mean, I think that the owner and the applicant are asking for very little from us as a town. And in return, the revenues that we will acquire, not only in the first 5-10 years, but beyond that, are really a financial sight to behold, it seems to me. I mean, if we look at the Mills redevelopment on the other side of the river, which Eric Chinberg also had the role in redeveloping, and we look at what the tax revenue from those mills was before the redevelopment and what it's been like since. I think the revenue before the redevelopment on that side of the river was in the I don't know, it was in the thousands to tens of thousands of dollars per annum, something of that kind, and now we're talking about millions. And it's been truly, and you know, we've gone from what was an eyesore and really kind of a liability for the community and a liability for the town, to something that's a marvel. And now, if we talk about this side of the river, and we talk about the buildings that front Main Street, the buildings that the so-called boomerang building that fronts the river, and we look at all those buildings in the complex, now we're talking about two or three times at least. I don't know the exact figures, obviously, but we're looking at two or three times the financial advantage that we had before. And so not only are we looking at a financial, we're looking at a very small investment in something that moves the community forward financially, but not just financially. It also moves the community forward in other ways. It moves us forward aesthetically. It moves us forward culturally. There'll be public and civic space as part of this revitalization. It moves us forward in terms of bringing people into the mills who will then service our downtown businesses. So therefore, it is good for the downtown businesses. We're looking at all these advantages at once, and I always feel, and I can't speak for my Newmarket Main Street Corporation board, but I'm sure members of that board always feel that investing a little bit for a lot of return financially is always a good thing, and that's what we're, you know, that's what we as a community should be here to do. We should be here to uphold our businesses, to uphold our downtown, which we've just spent a lot of money revitalizing anyway in terms of the corridor, the 108 corridor structure. We should always do that. And keep in mind that if Eric were not doing this and if we did not have this revitalization going on, what would we have with these buildings? We would have a liability, and one that ultimately we would end up paying for. Now, Eric says he's going to do it no matter what. But I just want to remind the council and our community that we're actually investing in the renovation and revitalization of something that would otherwise be an eyesore, and for longer at least, and a detriment to our community's well-being. So having said that, I'm in favor. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Anybody else like to speak? Mr. Badger.
John Badger, Cushing Road, and I'm speaking as an individual tonight. I would encourage the town council to support Eric Chinberg's application. And I was very impressed with what the previous gentleman just said. Think of the alternatives. The alternative is that Mr. Chinberg slogs his way through, as he said. The worst alternative is that nothing gets done, there's a liability, and the mills have to be torn down, because I think we're at the end of the opportunity to redevelop the mills. So I would encourage the town council to support Mr. Chinberg. This is a public-private kind of cooperation. We need that in Newmarket. It's vital to downtown, and I would encourage your support. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Badger. I have a couple things that I would like to, at this point, read into the record. excuse me. The first one is an email from Bernie Gordon to Ed Winowski. It's Ed. I would love to attend tonight's meeting, but probably can't because of a UNH obligation. The issue of seeking tax relief for any period, in this case up to 9 years, needs to be put in the following context. The town will in all likelihood have rising costs and revenue needs over the coming years. Thus, to some unknown degree, added tax revenue will have to be found in order to keep the town solvent. But if one taxpayer, parentheses, Chinberg in this instance, is given a tax break for some undetermined number of years, the logic is clear. The town's other taxpayers will have to make up the difference. That puts an unfair burden on everyone because, as you well know, there's no free lunch. I sure hope this logical and obvious point can be made at the meeting this evening. Warm regards, Bernie. That's one letter we have. I also have a letter from the Planning Board. It's addressed to myself. Dear Mr. Bodeman and members of the Town Council, I understand that Eric Chinberg, on behalf of the Newmarket Mills LLC, has submitted an application to the Town Council for tax relief, Chapter 79E, Community Revitalization Tax Relief Incentive. The Planning Board discussed this matter at our September 14th, 2010 meeting and wholeheartedly supports Mr. Chinberg's application. Mr. Chinberg's project to rehabilitate the mill buildings will become financially more viable if he can utilize the tax benefits allowed under 79E. As a result, the economic viability of New Market's downtown will be greatly enhanced through the rehabilitation of the underutilized mill buildings for a new housing, retail, commercial, and civic space. It will also improve a structure that is culturally and historically significant at a local, state, and national level as individual buildings as well as part of a larger historic district. The proposed mixed-use development is consistent with the New Market Master Plan and development regulations. A special use permit and site plan for this project were approved by the Planning Board in 2009. This project is consistent with our economic development goals to strengthen downtown as New Market's central business district, encourage new investment, add jobs, and expand to our tax base. Given the realities of today's economy, real estate market, and the tightening requirements of the lending institutions, board members feel it important to communicate our support of Mr. Chinberg in his 79E application. We feel that the town council should do whatever is appropriate and equitable to help Mr. Chinberg secure the financing that is required in order to make this project feasible. This may be the last opportunity for the town to redevelop the mills given their age and extent of deterioration. Members of the Planning Board will attend the public hearing on Wednesday, October 13, 2010, to hear his application and be available to answer any questions. Thank you for considering the Planning Board's position of support as you deliberate a decision so important to the future of New Market. Sincerely, John Badger, Chairman, New Market Planning Board. And lastly, in association with that, I received an email from Rick McMenamin, who is an alternate member on the Planning Board. And this was addressed to, I got a copy of it, it was addressed to Diane Hardy. I cannot support the letter as written because it is open-ended and does not set a time limit on the length of the relief. If support was for a certain time of 3 to 5 years, that is a maximum I could support. Like George, for those of you who don't know George, he's speaking of George Willant, another planning board member, I want to make sure the town is treated fairly as well as Mr. Chinberg. I agree Mr. Chinberg needs some relief, but it must be for a time certain, way less than 9 years. Thanks, Rick McMenamin. And lastly, I have a letter from Kennebunk Savings addressed to myself in relation to the New Market Mills project. I am writing in connection with Eric Chinberg's proposed New Market Mills project. Mr. Chinberg has requested that Kennebunk Savings Bank provide financing for this project. The project that was initially presented to the bank included 38,000 square feet of commercial space. As a result of the intended use of the New Market's tax credit, without which this project would not be possible, the amount of commercial space has been increased to 55,000 square feet. Only a small portion of this commercial space is committed to tenants at this point, and given high commercial vacancy rates, it is challenging to pre-lease any commercial space, let alone this quantity of commercial space. In connection with our review of Mr. Chinberg's application, the bank commissioned an appraisal of this project. We have received that appraisal, and it will not support the loan amount that this project will require at the loan-to-value ratio that the bank has approved. I expect that the grant of an RSA 79E benefit by the town would result in a significant increase in value of the project and hopefully support the needed loan amount. This is because a RSA 79E benefit will reduce the operating expenses for the project, thereby increasing the project's net income. In turn, that increase in projected net income will allow the appraiser to increase his determination of the current market value of the project. Sincerely, James Thompson, Vice President of Kennebunk Savings Bank. Thank you. I wanted to read those into the record. Does anybody else want to speak? Mr. Jablonski, please state your name and address.
Jablonski, 30 Bay Road. My question here is that I'm listening to a lot of talk about this, and we should do that or whatever. And my concern is taxes. I'm not going to get a COLA increase in taxes. And I'm going to have to pay taxes for someone who's going to get a tax relief. My question to the council is this. Has the council figured out proportionally how much of an increase the taxpayers of New Market will have to make up if you approve this tax relief project? Can you give me an answer on that? Can you say to me, Chet, your taxes are going to increase 2% because of this, plus 4% the town's going to give me another increase in taxes? Or is just this another thing of saying to me, we don't have a plan, there's no goals, there's no objectives, and there's no time restraints or any type of time situations at all in this town. I told you that before, and I'm telling you again. Set up goals and objectives and follow them, because we as taxpayers are doing that. We can't keep increasing or throwing out $2,000 a year increase in taxes.
Chet, let me stop you.
No, I'm not going to stop.
Yeah,
I'm telling you right now, this is what I'm figuring out.
I understand that. We're here to talk about 79E. If you want to talk about taxes,
and 79E, you're talking about tax relief, aren't you?
This is a particular application we're talking about.
Well, that's exactly what I'm talking
about.
Keep it
to that subject.
If you approve this, are you going to be able to guarantee that we're going to, proportionally, we're not going to get a tax increase because of this?
We haven't made any decisions yet, Chet.
All right. Well, I didn't ask you to. I asked you if you did approve this. I put the if in, I think. All right?
Yep. Thank you. Anybody else?
I'm Peter Roy from Loveland Drive. I just want to make one small point. Eric has come before us many times, and he's spoken this evening about what would happen if he did not get 79E. And I think the alternative is one that we have to think about a little bit, and that is that he would proceed on what I would refer to in probably kind of casual way of, as a piecemeal development. In other words, as you rent something out, you build it out and so forth and so on. I just would like to have you picture what the revitalization of downtown would have been like if we had taken a section of sidewalk and built it out 1 month, and a year later put up a couple of light poles, and then maybe 2 years later widened the road and so forth. This is a project that, in order to continue with the revitalization that we've begun with, a revitalization project downtown, the town is already lifting. And if this were to come to pass as a piecemeal type of development, I think it would be a mistake. And I hope that the board, the council, excuse me, considers this when they discuss the 79E. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Anybody else? Mr. Chaffee.
Arlen Chaffee, 2 Packers Falls Road. I think a point that needs to be made here is not that it's relief from a current tax value. So in other words, we're not seeking to grant relief from somebody's paying $100,000. Hey, can they pay $50,000? That person's getting a deal. I'm not. This is more going forward, you have the ability to increase your tax base so that everybody's tax, individual tax rolls will be that much less in the future. So it's looking more toward that rather than a takedown now. It's delivering it later. So
can I ask you a question?
Sure.
What does NCDC does not pay any taxes on the mill?
Payment right. In lieu of taxes is $13,000, and Eric, based on current appraisal today, right now. So as of right now, it'd be a $40,000 tax bill. And the estimate is completed project 220 to 240 per annum.
So initially there's a increase in $27,000, is that?
That would be the indicated increase between what the NCDC as a private nonprofit was paying to the town as under pilot, as opposed to assessed value against the tax rate for a commercial entity.
Okay. Mr. Chinberg, could you come up here for a minute? I have a question for you.
Let me just clarify that. Based on the assets, the properties that I purchased from NCDC, and now I'm not subject to the $13,000 payment in lieu, as of today, I'll be paying $45,011 per annum to the town, an increase of $32,000. So that would be a baseline. And so we're simply asking for relief from anything above that.
So for every, if relief were granted, you would pay a minimum of $45,000.
That's
if
right.
I understand the law correctly, that would increase with the increase value of the property, not associated with
If the relief is granted, it's granted for value added post the granting of relief. So right now, the assessed valuation of the parcels that I own is $2,058,000.
So right now, I'm starting to churn a clock at $45,000 a year. And by the way, and if I can do the buy the other parcels, Eagles, Riverdale, the parking lots, all that, the assessed valuation goes up by $711,000. That's not value, and I'll be paying $60,000 a year. So if I get, I go to $60,000 a year on day one if I get the loan closing and buy the rest of the parcels. So if I get 79E and I buy the rest of the parcels in February, it's 60 grand a year just by virtue of buying Riverdale and buying Eagles. Then I would just be seeking relief for sticks and bricks and mortar that we put in addition to that.
And then if in spite of what Chet wants, if the tax rate goes up in town, your taxes would go up.
Yes. So I'm
For the $2,058,000, whatever it's assessed at.
$258,000 right now. If I bought the other parcels, it would be $2.8 million. And so if the tax rate goes beyond 21, whatever, I'd keep paying that.
Okay. Thank you.
Remember the word I used, proportionally. All right. I'm not saying that it's not going to give us a relief, or because if he doesn't get the, or if he doesn't pay his extra taxes. But what if he does pay it, we won't pay less. We will pay less. If he pays his $27,000, we'll pay less. That's what I'm saying.
I understand. I understand your position. All right. Absolutely. Yep.
And the other thing is, in terms of the Eagles, I've been watching this, and the taxpayers of Newmarket, that's their money, have bought the Eagles, it's my understanding, through NCDC. And I'd like to know, why isn't this money given back to the taxpayers? You know, it's going to be part of this project, and
the money will go into the, correct me if I'm wrong, when payment is made, the money will go into the general fund.
Yes.
And so in any particular year when that's done, that could be a surplus that could be given back to the taxpayers.
And
there's been no
exactly
decisions
right.
made on
if it goes into the general fund, it should go back to the taxpayers in terms of tax relief.
Understood.
And the other question is, the previous person who spoke, he mentioned the fact that this is not about taxing. Well, if it isn't about taxing, why are you calling it a tax credit? That's my question. Is it is all taxes.
Anybody else? Roseanne?
In regards to Rick's letter, how many years is Mr. Chinberg looking for in his contract for the tax incentive, the 79E?
Oh. I wanted the opportunity to clarify that. I am specifically seeking 3 years post-completion with no increase based on the work, and then in years 4 and 5, pay 50% of the taxes from the improvements. So it would be 3 years full and 2 years half. At the end of the 5th year, it would be the full thing.
So would he be willing to sign that he will not be applying for the additional 4 years that he would be eligible to, because you can go up to 9 years?
Yes.
Well, if the council voted to grant relief, all those details would be in. The covenant is basically an agreement between the parties. The covenant would address all those issues.
And in regards to what Chet was asking about the taxpayers and if they're going to end up paying anything extra, if he gets his loan, which I think would be great, and he can build out, and within a year we could have it fully done. At that point, I believe through the planning board process, he had what it would cost the town to service that entire project finished. And I believe it was $137,000 a year. When you're talking fire, ambulance, so forth and so on. So technically, for the first 3 years of this, if NCDC is paying $10,000-$13,000 and change, Mr. Chinberg's going to be paying $45,000 and change, which is an increase of $27,000. Within 1 year's time, when that is completely built out, our cost as a town to keep that place plowed and whatever services the town is obligated to do, fire, police, ambulance, and so forth, is going to cost approximately $137,000. So that, in effect, is a cost to the taxpayers, because we will not be getting that additional tax money for 3 years. The 4th and 5th year we'll be getting 50%, and that's more enough to compensate for that. But I remember seeing that meeting and it would be $137,000 that it would cost the town. And that was an appraisal, so to speak, that Mr. Chinberg himself did. And that's what it would cost the town. So technically, for the first 3 years, it would cost the town about just short of $100,000 for us to support the services needed. So it will cost the town, us taxpayers, $300,000. I'm in favor of the project. I mean, it's going to be better than what we're looking at now. But, you know, these are little things that should be brought up so people know exactly what it's costing everybody. Thanks.
Thank you. Mr. Jablonski.
Mr. Chinberg stated the fact that in 3 years post-completion, he's going to get a tax relief if you approve this. 4 to 5 years, he's going to pay back 50% of the improvement of the project. But what time is he going to pay the 100%?
After 5 years.
After 5 years.
So the first 3 years, he would pay nothing of the increase. The second 2 years, he'd pay 50%. And the third, or the fifth year on, he would pay the full thing.
All right, thank you.
Mr. Badger.
I didn't think I would come back up here again. I'm troubled by what Ms. Quack said about $137,000 in the context of the planning board. I don't remember any number like that. I've just asked the vice chairman. He doesn't remember. I've asked our member. He doesn't remember any number like that. Ms. Quack needs to explain the $137,000. She indicated that Mr. Chinberg came up with that number. Maybe he can talk about it, but I can tell you that's a new number. We don't know anything about $137,000 that she says it's going to cost the town.
Right. I think what Ms. Quox is referring to is the financial analysis that was done by Mr. Chinberg. And I don't remember whether $137,000 is the correct number, but he did put together. Do you remember what that is, Mr. Chinberg?
Yeah, I just don't want a number hanging out there, an allegation that is, we need to get the bottom of it. Thank you.
I don't recall. We were asked to do a financial, I forget the name of it. It's kind
impact
of
study.
Impact
basically.
Study. And it's formulaic. So you say, oh, if you're adding a unit, then you allocate X dollars per unit for fire and X for there is no plowing. Very little impact on schools because we expect no school children. So it was formulaic, and I don't remember what it was. It was some number. And we showed that our tax revenue is going to be $200,000 or whatever, and it's a clear win. So it's possible that if those numbers are real, the prorated numbers, and there really is some cost where we're only paying $45,000 or $60,000 for a year or two. I do want to just sort of bring back, and I didn't address this earlier, but in doing the whole approval process before I knew about tax credits or trying to figure it all out, I needed the parking, and I negotiated a 62-year lease with the town for the big parking lots. All I have to pay for 62 years is what the property taxes would have been. The tax credit buyers don't want leased land as collateral. So part of the deal is if I get the whole tax credit closing, I'm going to come to you guys and say, instead of me paying you what I'd pay anyway for property taxes, I want to pay you $200,000-$300,000, whatever the assessed value of those lots are, just under $300,000. I want to pay you that money because the tax credit people are putting in that money because they don't want to lend on leased collateral. So to the extent there was a 2 or 3 year period where if those costs are higher than the $60,000, you'd have that in the bank from the beginning because you'd be getting cash for those lots plus the tax revenue rather than 62 years of just rent that equals tax revenue.
Right, thank you. For the record, I do remember, I don't remember the exact number, but I remember the study that Mr. Chinberg did, and there was a net positive cash flow to the town of $125,000 a year upon completion, but it was based on the deductions on that where, you know, the project was assessed so much of the police costs and so much of the fire costs, which, like Mr. Chinberg said, probably are more systematic. They're not additional costs that the project's going to bring to the town because we're not going to add firefighters or policemen because of that, but I do remember the study was part of the approval for was it a special exception? Special permit. It was probably a special permit. All right. Does anybody have any other questions for Mr. Chinberg or anybody else? Anybody in the audience? Everybody's all set for now? I thank you all for coming. With that, I'm going to close the public hearing at 7:55 or so. Thank you all for coming.
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Motion passes.
Thanks, Eric.